Okay, I need some inspiration. Give me a color.
Silver?
Silver. Oh wow. For some reason, when I was thinking about, I was like, oh, she's gonna say like pink or purple or green. It was silver. Oh shit, do I even have any silver?
Should I go with a different one?
Okay, give me another color.
Okay, pink.
Okay. So this is the Urban Decay. I forgot what palette it is, but I don't use it too often. But just like for like toppers and stuff. But I'm just kind of going through what I have to see what I should do because I have silver here. Ooh, silver and pink. Do you think that would work? So
Yeah.
maybe I could use like this silver. Let me see, I think. So these are some really cool melt palettes. They cost quite a bit of money, but they're really good quality. For example, this is a Neon Stax, and then my pink one is smashed. Damn. Okay, this is definitely the Silver Stack, I think. There we go. Well, first of all, anyways, I need to set up a base. So get this. So this is concealer. I'm just gonna use this as a base. Because when you use Vivid Eyeshadow, you want it to really pop. So I never do this. Like daily makeup, I don't really do this because this is for like really intense looks.
So what made you want to do this today?
Sometimes I just get random bouts of not even inspiration because it's not like I don't even know what I want to do today, but just sometimes I'm like I want to create something with color, you know?
Yeah.
And then I will just look at my makeup until something comes to me, basically. I started getting into makeup in junior year of high school, so when I was like maybe 17, which I actually think it's a pretty late start considering a lot of girls get into makeup like in middle school, you know, when they're like a little bit younger. But even then, I started getting into makeup, and then I didn't fully get into it until university. So I was 18, and then I started exploring with like eyeshadow and color and all that.
Yeah.
So I have an idea. I'm thinking I'm gonna do a halo eye with pink and silver today. So that is pink on the outer and inner corner with a pop of silver in the middle. I'm no pro, I don't even know what to use, so I'm just grabbing anything I have to in hopes that it will help my process here.
Dang, girl. That is very hot. Hot pink.
So a lot of pro makeup artists, they will do one eye first before doing the other eye. I can't do that. I have to do both at the same time.
Why is that?
I think for them, it's like, okay, you complete one and then you kind of recreate the other. But that's because they can imitate their own actions. I will have forgotten already how to imitate it. And also, I'm a freak when it comes to this, but I like to keep my brushes clean. So like, after using every color, I have to wash it, right? But then if I do one eye first and then the other, that means I have to wash each brush twice. This way, I can also make sure that they're even. I bet you that my eyelids are gonna be stained pink tonight.
Your eyelids?
Yeah, because sometimes with these like really intense colors, the dyes that they use in it could stain your skin for a little bit. So like, look at the brush. Right now, I'm debating between this silver versus this one. This one is this one, and I feel like it's a more finely milled eyeshadow. Mm. This one is chunkier, which is actually what I want. Mm-hmm. Just slightly blend it in with my fingers. Do you see that slight gradient effect? With the pink, that's really nice, actually.
It's kind of purpley now.
Yeah. Just kind of blend the edges a little bit here. Then I'm going to use a fluffy brush and just to soften the edges here. So usually when people do these like really intense looks, they like to do a cut crease, which is basically like when your eyeshadow has like a very distinct cut between the colors. I personally like it when my colors are a little bit more blended out. So like the way I'm softening the edges here.
Why do you prefer softening out rather than having that clear cut?
Even though I like colors and everything, I'm not a big fan of like makeup that like looks like it's just straight up paint. I do like it to be ironically a little bit natural. I mean, it's not natural of course, but like ethereal, kind of like blending into like my skin and whatnot. See, even me doing this right now, it gives it a much more natural like it doesn't even look that intense right now, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, in my eyes.
I dig.
Okay, so this is Fenty Beauty. It's like a kind of like a glitter palette. I'm just gonna use this one, maybe more icy white. Here. Then I'm gonna go with this color here. Then back to this brush. I'm just going to blend it out a little bit. Maybe I'll add a little bit of this color, light pink, and just blend out this shade here. There we go. It's a little bit more diffused now. And I think for the color part, we are done. So what do I want to do now is the real question. I don't even want to put eyeliner, so I'm just going to put mascara on. But, ooh, before I do that, so I'm going to use this. It's just a black eyeliner, and I'm gonna use this to tight line just because I have sparse eyelashes, and so I want to make it seem like I have like a full lash line. But I'm not really gonna do a wing or anything because I already have that wing shape with the
Someone's sending you a message.
Ding 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 ding. Ding. It's like, for a look like this, if I want to make it super dramatic, I can put like black liner and false lashes and everything, but I feel like just doing this kind of mascara with a little bit of tight lining almost makes it more wearable, you know? Like, it's just, oh, I don't know, I feel kind of like Euphoria. Like, Euphoria, hire me. HBO, hire me. I'm not really about glam, and I like streetwear a lot more, so like this is kind of like, it's not glam per se, you know, I can make it glam if I want it to, but it's more like casual street, streetwear makeup. There you go. That's my personal brand. So like today, all I did was my brows and my eyes. I didn't even put on, I don't have any face makeup on, which is why you can see all my like hairs and freckles and everything, but you know what? This is it. Honestly, like, I will go out like this. Like, I will totally go out like this. So this is your new quarantine inspiration, you know? You can do this. Go out to your local grocery stores, wink at your local cute boy or girl. Be like, hey. And this concludes today's pink and silver inspired look.